You know, a lot of people ask me, what was it like in the Old West? So today on the Armchair Traveler, we're not going to travel to an exotic location. We're going to travel in time back to the Old West of the 1800s. That's not water. You know, politicians in the mid-1800s believed it was the United States' destiny to reach from coast to coast. Remember that the 13 original colonies were on the east coast of the United States, and politicians thought that it was our duty to spread across the country and reach the west coast, and this thought or this belief was called the manifest destiny. A popular slogan at the time was, "Go West, young man." And this was made famous by reporters who were trying to encourage people to go West and try to earn a living. Oh, God. There's gold in them there hills. Not grammatically correct, but also a popular saying at the time. One of the most important things that shaped the character as well as the boundaries of the U.S. was the gold rush. Notice that in Spanish you say fiebre de oro, which literally translated would be gold fever. As an interesting side note or anecdote, a young merchant by the name of Levi Strauss, that might sound familiar, Levi Strauss, Los Levis, invented a fabric that was durable that the miners could use and would last them a long time. The famous denim, or denim is where that name comes from, was used to make the first blue jeans. Of course, the prospect of making a lot of money, of striking it rich, of hitting the jackpot, mining or panning for gold, brought people from all over the world. Not only Americans from the East, but it brought Mexicans, Chinese people who later worked on the railroads, Peruvians, even Spaniards went to California in search of fortune. Because there was so much money at stake, tanto dinero en juego, and the fact that most of the prospectors carried their own firearm, lawlessness was somewhat common, and the figure of the sheriff became very, very important. In fact, if you have been to San Francisco or also Vancouver, British Columbia, Seattle, and Los Angeles, you might have noticed that there are very large Chinatowns in those towns, and these are left over from the days of this massive Chinese immigration. Ha ha, four aces. Read them and weep. I'm Colby Price, and you're watching More Than English TV.